Hello friends, good to see you again. Today we'll talk about sculpture. 今天我们要谈论雕塑。First, let's look at a picture. 这是 Henry Moore 与他的雕塑作品 Reclining Figure, 躺着的人体。和绘画一样，雕塑作品是艺术家的形象思维。但与绘画不同的是，它不是平面，而是立体的。我们可以用手去触摸雕塑，去感觉它的质感。我们还可以在它周围走来走去，用不同角度去感受它不同的外观。作为一种立体艺术，雕塑被认为是所有艺术当中最难的艺术。因此呢，欣赏雕塑作品也需要学习。那么，我们如何学习欣赏雕塑作品呢？那Let's listen to the text and then answer this question. What do you have to be able to do to appreciate sculpture? 你必须具备什么能力才能欣赏雕塑呢?
Appreciation of sculpture depends upon the ability to respond to form in three dimensions.That is perhaps why sculpture has been described as the most difficult of all arts. Certainly, it is more difficult than the arts which involve appreciation of flat forms, shape in only two dimensions. Many more people are form blind than color blind. The child learning to see first distinguishes only two-dimensional shape. It cannot judge distances.Depths. Later, for its personal safety and practical needs, it has to develop, partly by means of touch, the ability to judge roughly three-dimensional distances. But having satisfied the requirements of practical necessity, most people go no further. Though they may attain considerable accuracy in the perception of flat form, they do not make the further intellectual and emotional effort neededto comprehend form in its full spatial existence. This is what the sculptor must do. He must strive continually to think of and use form in its full spatial completeness. He gets the solid shape, as it were, inside his head. He thinks of it, whatever its size, as if he were holding it completely enclosed in the hollow of his hand. He mentally visualizes a complex form,from all round itself. He knows while he looks at one side what the other side is like. He identifies himself with its center of gravity, its mass, its weight. He realizes its volume as the space that the shape displaces in the air. And the sensitive observer of sculpture must also learn to feel shape simply as shape, not as description or reminiscence. He must, for example, perceive an egg as a simple, single, solid shape, quite apart from its significance as food, or from the literary idea that it will become a bird. And so with solids, such as a shell, a nut, a plum, a pear, a tadpole, a mushroom, a mountain peak, a kidney, a carrot,A tree trunk, a bird, a bud, a lark, a ladybird, a bulrush, a bone. From these, he can go on to appreciate more complex forms or combinations of several forms.
刚才的问题是 What do you have to be able to do to appreciate sculpture? 回答应该是You have to be able to respond to form in three dimensions. 你必须对立体有反应能力。Right, you've got it. 回答正确。现在我们来看一下整篇课文的内容。这是一篇有关雕塑的说明文，说明雕塑家的一些特点，以及我们应该如何欣赏雕塑。课文一共有三段，第一段提出论题，雕塑是立体艺术，然而我们多数人都是形盲， form blind， 也就是说缺少对三维空间距离的判断和欣赏能力。第二段讲雕塑艺术家的特点，他们具备全方位视角的观察能力，也就是说他看到物体的一边时便能知道物体的另一边是什么样子，他能够敏锐地意识到物体的体积 realize its volume。 第三段讲我们应该如何学会欣赏雕塑，作为雕塑的观赏者，我们要首先学会把形体当着形体去感觉，而不要用描述或印象去感觉。好，在这篇课文当中，雕塑家 Henry Moore 尽量用一种平实的语言，短小精悍的句子来告诉我们普通人如何去欣赏雕塑。理解了课文大意，再来学习重要语言点。So let's move on to language points. 先看这一句。Appreciation of sculpture depends upon the ability to respond to form in three dimensions. Dimension 意思是 a measurement in any one direction. 这本来是一个数学用语，为数度。Form in three dimensions, 三维体的，也就是立体。我们来看下面几个表达法。Form in three dimensions, 我们也可以说 three-dimensional form, 立体。Form in two dimensions,也可以说 flat form， 还可以说 two-dimensional form， 平面体。这句话主要讲，由于雕塑是一种立体艺术，如果我们对立体的感觉比较强的话，就能更好的欣赏雕塑，那么反过来也一样。好， dimension， 我们来看两个例句。To me, he is a real person in three dimensions. 在我看来，他是一个真正的立体的人。The baby has added a new dimension to our lives. 这个孩子为我们的生活增加了一个新的方面。好，看下一个语言点。Certainly, it is more difficult than the arts which involve appreciation of flat forms, shape in only two dimensions. Involve. Include something as a necessary part or result. 包含或者需要的意思。Arts which involveAppreciation of flat forms， 就是说需要欣赏平面体的艺术，即平面艺术。这句话主要讲欣赏立体艺术呢，比平面艺术要难得多。根据下文，作者解释了原因，这是因为我们大部分人都是形盲 ，form blind。虽然我们对平面的感觉能达到相当准确的程度，但往往不能理解 the form in its full spatial existence， 不能理解存在于空间的整个形态。好， involve， 我们来看两个例句。 Being a successful person involves a great deal of hard work，做一个成功者需要付出艰苦的劳动。Any reform involves some element of risk. 任何改革都包含某种风险因素。 learning to see first distinguishes only two dimensions. Distinguish, to recognize the differences between things. 分辨出的意思。 Distinguish only two dimensions. 分辨出平面体。 这句话主要讲刚学会看东西的儿童， 只能分辨出平面体。Distinguish. 我们来看两个例句。 It's important to distinguish between written English and spoken English. 辨别出书面英语和口语很重要。 It's important to distinguish facts from rumors, as there's too much yellow journalism going on in the mass media. 眼下大众媒体中耸人听闻的东西太多了，所以辨别事实和传闻很重要。Distinguish facts from rumors. 意思是辨别事实和传闻。好，再来看下一句。 He identifies himself with its center of gravity, its mass, its weight. Identify oneself with something. 意思是 to feel oneself closely connected or involved with something or somebody. 与什么什么成为一片，或者与什么什么打成一片。 Identifies himself with its center of gravity, its mass, its weight. 与物体的重心、质量和重量融为一体。这句话主要讲雕塑家往往用一个全方位的视角来看待一个实体。好，我们来看一个例句。 Identify oneself with. Identify oneself with something or somebody. 在这个短语当中，当代美国英语当中呢，反身代词 oneself 往往是省略的。我们来看一个例句。He didn't seem to be able to identify with ordinary people. 他好像不能与普通人打成一片。这句话也可以翻成，他好像不能理解普通人。好，再来看下一例句。He mentally visualizes a complex form from all round itself. Visualize, to form a picture of someone or something in your mind. 在脑中勾画出形象。Visualizes a complex form from all round itself. 从物体的各个角度出发，在脑中勾画出它复杂的一个形象。这句话主要讲雕塑家的特点，他们是用一种全方位的视角来看待实体。 They look at an object from all angles. 好, visualize. 我们来看两个例句。Try to visualize how you will look when you have your hair dyed. 设法想象出你染发后的形象。I can't visualize raising 5 or 6 children. 我真的难以想象养5、6个孩子。好，再看下一句。And the sensitive observer of sculpture must also learn to feel shape simply as shape, not as description or reminiscence. Reminiscence 意思是 thoughts of past experiences, 回忆。 not as description or reminiscence. 不要靠描写或者印象去感觉。Reminiscence 原来的意思是回忆，但在这儿翻译成印象好像更合适一些。这句话主要讲告诉我们如何敏锐地去欣赏雕塑，也就是说作者告诉我们在看一个物体的时候首先感觉到它的实体形态，而不要靠描写或者印象去感觉。比如说看到一个鸟蛋，首先要感觉到它是一个椭圆的实体形态，不要用抽象的文字去解释说这个鸟蛋可以吃，或者说可以变成鸟。总之我们要以形体出发去观察物体。好， reminiscence， 我们来看一例句。He likes reading reminiscences of the war. 他喜欢阅读战争回忆录。That's all for the language points. Now let's move on to key structures. 先看这一句。But having satisfied the requirements of practical necessity, most people go no further. 这句话相当于 after they have satisfied the requirements of practical necessity, most people go no further. 在这句里面，现在分词完成体做状语，表示时间。这种句式往往用于书面语体，比较正式。我们再来看两个例句。Having reached a high level in English, he started to learn German. 他英语达到一个较高水平后，开始学德语了。Having worked in this company for 5 years, he moved to a bigger one. 在这个公司工作了5年后，他调到了一个更大的公司。好，再来看最后一句。He gets the solid shape, as it were, inside his head. He thinks of it, whatever its size, as if he were holding it completely enclosed in the hollow of his hand. 可以这样说，他脑子里先有一个实体，无论这个实体大小如何，他想象着这个实体好像完全握在自己的手心一样。这一句当中破折号后边的内容我们可以看成是作为前面一句的补充。As it were, 意思是可以这样说。这个短语经常放在一个句子的中间。我们来看两个例句。He became our idol, as it were, the man we all wanted to be. 他成了我们崇拜对象，可以说我们都想成为他那样的人。I'm sort of an unpaid advisor, as it were, to the committee. 可以说我是委员会的义务顾问。以前总觉得雕塑是一种高雅艺术，离我们的生活非常远。但近两年，北京街头出现了越来越多的雕塑，比如说王府井、西单文化广场是雕塑最集中的地方。这些雕塑去掉了底座，而直接放在地面上，我们突然感到雕塑开始融入社会，走进生活。随着城市雕塑的发展，相信我们对雕塑的艺术水平也会逐步提高，都会成为敏锐的雕塑观察家。但更重要的是，成为用全方位视角观察事物的人。I'm sure we can all become sensitive observers of sculpture, and more importantly, be able to look at things from different angles. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.